We really can't break the laws of physics. So how do we make them work for us so that we can do more or do something that we've never tried before? I'm Matthew Pess, and I lead advanced technology programs for power and controls at Collins Aerospace. EPACS is what we're calling the Enhanced Power and Cooling System. It's a group of technologies that we've brought together from our commercial platforms and our previous military work to see how we can apply that to a military application like the F-35. The challenge that EPACS is trying to solve is, how do you fit more than double the cooling capacity and still satisfy all the emergency power requirements in the same space? On the F-35, as they look at that next iteration of capabilities, they're looking at a 2.6x increase in the thermal capacity that's required to run those systems. That's an enormous change. There really isn't any extra room. They have packaged these things as tightly as physically possible because one of their key requirements is as lightweight as you can get and as much fuel as you can put on the airplane so that you can increase the range. But when we talk about the Pacific theater and the distances that are gonna have to be covered by these aircraft, now fuel burn becomes a real concern. We wanted to bring those commercial technologies that are really focused around efficiency, things that have been flying for millions and millions of hours, and see how we can apply that to a military application. We're working on a number of new technologies, which will be that next suite that builds on what we've done with EPACS for the fifth-gen fighter fleet. Power and thermal management is going to be a critical aspect of all of these next-gen platforms. When we see some of the use cases for a next-gen fighter, we're seeing 10x increases in the need for cooling and power. The more you go up in power, the more you go up in cooling, the more you start to really impact the engine's ability to do what it's on the airplane for, which is make thrust so that the airplane can fly. How do we bring together a suite of technologies to provide that additional capability on platforms that aren't changing in size? When we can find a way to solve a problem that nobody's thought of before, it's incredibly rewarding.